Mention Mykonos and a few images will spring to mind. Whether it is celebrities sunbathing on yachts, bright white Cycladic architecture, or paradisiacal beaches, you'll want to spend as much time as possible in the fashionable and arty Chora, getting share-worthy shots of the famous windmills and pure white houses. Even the cracks between the marble paving stones are painted white here. Welcome to Things to Do channel, we publish new content every day. So be sure to subscribe and don't forget to ring the bell to be updated on our latest videos. Here are 10 things to do in Mykonos. Stroll around Mykonos windmills. The first sight that hoves into view before you pull into the harbor is the row of 7 white windmills posted on a small cape. These would most likely have been built by the Venetians as long as the 16th century and are oriented to the north to catch the prevailing wind. They were built close to the harbor to mill grain offloaded from ships, to make it easier to transport. The mills have become a symbol for the whole island, and are a simple walk southwest of the Alefkandra Quarter. Shop at Matogianni Street. A north-to-south street through Mykonos Town, with little alleys darting off it, Matogianni Street is where it all happens. By day, you can idle along pursuing souvenir shops, boutiques, jewelry stores, and a couple of international chains like Sephora and Lacoste. When hunger strikes, you could opt for a souvlaki or gyro or sit down at one of many tavernas, which tend to be more reasonably priced here deeper in town. And in the evening, there's a delectable choice of restaurants at romantic spots, with bougainvillea climbing the walls and bars that do a roaring trade to the early hours. Explore Delos. The island of Delos is just a couple of kilometers from the southwest coast of Mykonos, and its excavations have been declared a UNESCO World Heritage Site. If you're up to scratch on Olympian Greek mythology, you may know Delos as the birthplace of the twin gods Apollo and Artemis. But more than 1,000 years beforehand, the island was already a venerated holy sanctuary. There's a lot to discover, like the Terrace of the Lions from the 7th century BC, the Doric Temple of the Delians, the Minoan Fountain, a series of market squares, and the Theater Quarter, laid with splendid mosaics. You can also see the phenomenal Hellenistic mosaics at the House of Dionysos, the House of Masks, House of the Trident, House of the Lake, and House of the Dolphins. Go back in time at Delos Archaeological Museum. After 30 years of excavation, the French School of Athens needed a museum for all its discoveries on Delos, and this was inaugurated in 1904. The archaeological digs have continued for more than 145 years, and the museum had to be expanded in 1931 and 1972 to accommodate all of this material. The oldest pieces here are ceramics going back more than 3,500 years. There are also numerous grave statues and steel from 17th to the 1st century BC, as well as clay figurines, mosaics, jewelry, and everyday items from the Hellenistic period. Among the must-sees is a bronze mask of Dionysus from the 2nd century BC, an ivory plate with a relief of Mycenaean warrior as old as 1400 BC, and a magisterial sculpture of Boreas kidnapping Orithia from the end of the 5th century BC. Check out Alefkandra. Around the western lip of the old harbor is a gorgeous web of little car-free alleys. These are laid with typical dark marble paving stones with cement coated with the same brilliant white paint as the houses. It's the waterside that gives Little Venice its nickname, where restaurants open to a narrow path less than a meter above the sea and tables for couples line the way. These buildings have slightly shambly wooden bay window boxes and balconies painted in blues and greens. Facing west, the sunsets are impossibly beautiful, so try to get a table before twilight and look down round to see the windmills catching the last rays. Be amazed at the old harbor. After catching the sea bus from the new port at Turlos, you'll disembark at the marble quays of the old harbor. On the east side are the arcades of Town Hall dating to the 1700s. In front of which is the tiny church of Agios Nikolaos, crowned with a blue dome. There's a string of bars and restaurants hugging the curve of the harbor, and if you investigate the side streets, you'll come across boutiques, design shops, and tasteful souvenir stores. shoulder to shoulder with quaint little churches, like Agia Eleni and Agios Kyrikos. Visit the Church of Panagia Paraportiani. Just north of Little Venice in the Castro neighborhood is the fascinating Church of Panagia Paraportiani. This monument was built between the 15th and 17th century and comprises four separate interconnected churches beneath a fifth built on top. The highest church is dedicated to the Virgin Mary and is easy to pick out for its dome. Catch some sun at Agios Sostis Beach. If you're craving for some space to yourself, make for the beaches in the less frequented north of Mykonos, which is scattered with natural parks. Agios Sostis has no beachfront bars, restaurants, or sunbeds, and is all better for it. The beach is noticeably quieter than those in the south, and behind is not much more gently sloping hills, sparsely dusted with scrub. Head north and there's a small village with a taverna and church, and another much smaller cove bathed by shallow glimmering water. A relaxing day at Kalafaris Beach. Two beaches over from Kalolivari, Kalafaris is another alluring sandy bay with an arc of golden sand and shallow, clear waters. What sets this beach apart is that it is oriented to the east, and not far offshore there are generous breezes. So while you recline on your sun lounger, you'll see windsurfing sails zipping across the horizon. Joining them in summer are some snazzy-looking yachts anchored in the bay. Kalafaris also has a water sports center for motorized activities like wakeboarding, water skiing, and jet skiing. See the Arministis Lighthouse. 6 kilometers north of Chora is a working lighthouse guiding traffic along the strait between Mykonos and neighboring Tinos. Positioned far above the water, this edifice was completed with an octagonal tower in 1891 and flashes a white signal every 10 seconds. It was raised in response to a disaster in which the vaulted team ship sank off the north coast of Mykonos in 1887 at the cost of 11 lives. If you'd like to see the original Fresnel lens, it has ended up at the Mykonos Maritime Museum. Although you can't go inside, the lighthouse is a trip worth making for the awesome scenery.